guys, happy Friday. It is Friday once again, and I am at WW. It's about 6:15. My meeting will open up here in about 15 minutes. I'm a little early today, but I am here, and I'm excited to go in, weigh in, see all my friends at my workshop since I went to the Wednesday workshop last week. I'm super excited to catch up with all of my friends, see my leader. Yeah. Excited to be here. So let's talk about my week. My camping trip was so much fun. So much fun. The video of the vlog and a little bit of what I ate and kind of just day in the life of our camping trip will be posted on this upcoming Sunday. So definitely look for that. And as far as food went on camping, I did pretty darn good. I used my weeklies on Friday, and then I was good Thursday and Saturday. And then going into this week, I started strong, but finished not so strong. I mentioned a couple of times in my Instagram stories that I have some huge life changes coming my way. So I have been extremely busy this last week with meetings and just doing research and meeting with people regarding the changes that are coming my way. So my food was not that fantastic. There were nights that I had to just grab something on my way home because it was late. It's been a little bit stressful. Not only is my job stressful, which I've mentioned before, but just trying to get this new thing going and really, you know, evaluating and thinking about where I'm, what I'm doing moving forward in my life. I know this is super vague, guys, but it's come. I will let you guys know as soon as decisions are made and T's are crossed and I's are dotted and it's a done deal. So I will keep you guys, of course, in the loop. I tell you guys everything, so I want to make sure that you are in the loop of what's going on in my life. But it just was a really crazy week, and there were several days that I didn't make the best choices. Plus, I was really hungry this last week. I don't know why. It is not Shark Week. It's not before Shark Week. So who knows why? But I was seriously really hungry a lot of this week. So I don't know how it's going to look when I get on the scale today. And honestly, with everything going on, it's not that I don't care, because I do care, but it was kind of put on the back burner this last week, just a little bit with everything that I have going on. As you know, if you are part of my Facebook group, I start the Wendy plan today. So today is my first day. I get 34 points today, so 1 point more than normal, and I'm so excited. It'll keep me on track 100% for sure, because on the Wendy plan, you have to eat all of your points that the calculator gives you. So I will be a filming fool over the next week, because I'm going to document the entire week on the Wendy plan. And of course, you'll see my results next Friday as usual, but I'm going to let you know like how I'm feeling, how I feel about the fluctuation of points. Am I able to eat all my points? Do I want to cry the day that my points drop way down after a high point day? So I'm really excited to share that with you guys. So I know that next week's weigh-in should be hopefully really good and very interesting after following the Wendy plan for an entire week. So again, I don't know what's going to happen when I weigh in, but I'm starting fresh today, no matter what, because I start the Wendy plan today. So super excited. If you don't know what the Wendy plan is, or you want to take part in my group that we're doing the Wendy plan, and let me tell you, there is a lot of us. We have over 4,100 people in my Facebook group, which is insane. And there is a big, large handful of us doing the Wendy plan this next week. Go ahead and go over to my Facebook group. It's right there on the screen for you. Join my group. There is an announcement that is at the top of the group that talks about the Wendy plan. And then, of course, feel free to ask any questions that you have. But I'm excited to do it as a trial and error. I am not switching to the Wendy plan. I am not getting off of Freestyle. I've had a few people say that. No, this is just a trial and run for a week, maybe two, just to see if it jumpstarts my weight loss, how I'm feeling. I'm always curious to try new things. So this is one of those new things. So definitely hop over to my Facebook group if you want to know a little bit more about the Wendy plan, or if you want to participate in it with all of us. So I'm going to head into my workshop, weigh in. I'll be back to deliver not only my results, but also to give you a recap of this week's topic. Hey guys, I just left my WW workshop and I'm on my way to work. So I thought that I'd use my camera mount here and talk to you guys a little bit about the topic before I get to work, and we'll finish it out there. So this week's topic was a fantastic one. Like I said, Weight Watchers, they got it going on. Like whenever I need a topic, it seems to be the topic that is at the workshop. So today we talked about how to ace a summer party. And as you know, there are tons of parties throughout the summer. Everything ranging from graduation to barbecues to Father's Day, even Mother's Day at the beginning of summer, 4th of July. There are just party after party after party during the summer. So WW wants to help you ace those parties, stay on track, and not see a gain on the scale when you have a party or parties to attend in a given week. So it's perfect timing. Like I said, with summer just beginning, just kicking off, the weather is just getting to the perfect summer temperature. So for me, I have a few summer get-togethers, no graduations or anything like that, but I do have, you know, 4th of July. And in fact, this Saturday, I have my in-laws over for a barbecue at our house. If you are interested in seeing some great barbecue or grill recipes, I do have an entire series here on my YouTube channel. I'm gonna put a picture right here of my recent barbecue series video. Check it out. It's gonna give you some options for low point or WW friendly foods that you can not only make at your barbecue, but even bring to your summer parties to help you stay on track, and everything is delicious. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the three things that WW says that you can do to ace your summer parties. So the first thing that you can do to ensure some success at your summer parties is to think about your plate size. So the bigger the plate, the more food we want to put on it. And if we only put a little bit of food on a big plate, we don't feel like we're getting our food because our plate is so large and our portion is so small. So one tip is get a small plate. So instead of those big dinner size plates or the large paper plates, if you are a paper party, grab a small dessert plate or a small paper plate. They generally have those for desserts at barbecues and parties as well. So grab a smaller plate and fill that up with your foods. That way you feel like you're getting a full meal or a large amount of food, but really you aren't overeating because you can only put so much food on those small plates. So that is my first recommendation. WW's first recommendation is use the smaller dessert plates versus the large dinner plates. Now, what do you fill your plate with? So my first tip is think islands, not continents. So when you're putting food on your plate, give yourself the island theory. Make that portion the size of an island, not an entire continent. That way you're staying within your portions, you're not overeating, you're demonstrating some portion control without having to measure, because an island is certainly a lot smaller than an entire continent. So think the philosophy of islands versus continents when you're putting the food on your plate. Now, you can change it up a little bit, and if you're eating, say, a green salad or some fruit or some veggies, you can really think more on the continent side. But a rule of thumb is think islands versus continents. Secondly, make sure that the first thing you're putting on your plates and the largest portion of your plate is 0 point foods. So look for the chicken, look for the veggies, look for the fruits. Make that the biggest portion on your small plate. And that way you don't have enough room to fill it with non-WW friendly items or point heavy items. That doesn't mean that you can't have those things. You just have less room on your plate for those things. So definitely fill your plate, fill your belly with 0 point foods or low point foods first. So next, let's talk about tracking. So when we're at these summer parties or these barbecues, we don't always know what the points value is in the foods that we're eating, because a lot of time these type of events are potlucks and such, where people are bringing food items and you don't know what they use necessarily, the brand, the amount. So it can be hard to track your smart points. However, if you search in the WW app for baked beans, you can use a general baked bean smart point value. It is important to continue to track. Even if you overindulge at your summer parties, still track it so you can see where you fall as far as smart points are concerned. Also, make sure you eat a lot of what you bring to the party, because that, you know what the smart points is, you know what was put into that, you know the amounts, you know the ingredients. So really focus on what you brought to the table for the party, because at least you know what the smart points are. But most importantly, just track your smart points. Do your best to guesstimate your smart points, and I would recommend that you're mentally tracking throughout the party. So you're really thinking as you're going and collecting your food throughout the party what the smart points are. And then the first thing that you should do when you have a free moment, maybe it's in the restroom at the party, or maybe it's the minute you hop in your car after the party, track everything that you ate at the party so that you know exactly where you are and how many points you may or may not have left over. So now I'm at work. So sunglasses off, we're no longer moving. So you can ace your summer parties. Just be cognizant of what you're eating. Remember the island versus continent theory. Fill up on those 0 point foods and make sure that the dish that you're bringing to the party, you know that you can eat. People aren't even gonna know that it's a WW recipe because generally the recipes are so good that you wouldn't know the difference whether they were WW or not. So set yourself up for success and don't forget you have your weeklies. And guess what? If you overindulge, it's okay. Give yourself some grace. Just hop back on track the next meal, the next day, and that's that. Enjoy your summer. Enjoy your summer get-togethers. And don't feel that you can't go or don't not go because you're on WW. The beauty of this program is we can eat whatever we want to eat as long as it's within our points. So go have fun. Enjoy the company. Have a glass of wine. Have a beer. Indulge in your favorite foods. Just track them. And again, get back on track as soon as you can if you happen to overindulge. So now let's talk about this week's weigh-in. So like I mentioned, I had a little bit of a rough week. It was an extremely busy week. I didn't make the best food choices. So when I got on the scale today, I actually gained 0.8. So I gained what I had lost last week. Now, it could have been a lot worse. It could have been a lot worse. So I'm going to take it as a win. 0.8 is just shy of a pound. I know that with the Wendy plan and being 100% on track this next week, that I can make up that 0.8. And I also wanted to share with you guys that even though my food choices weren't always the best this last week, I walked 4 days. 4 days. And while we were camping, I got at least 15 to 20,000 steps a day. So my activity was on point. So it is proof in the pudding that you can't exercise away what you're eating. Because if you think about all the exercise I did, you would think that I would have lost on the scale this week. So that is not what happened. I gained 0.8. I am back on track. Today is my first day on the Wendy plan. I cannot wait to do this vlog and take you guys with me through the entire week and show you everything that I'm eating, how I'm feeling. I'm super excited. Again, if you're interested in joining our Wendy plan challenge, Facebook group is right here on the screen. Make sure that you join because we are going to have a big group discussion daily, several times a day about how the Wendy plan is going. So it was a good week overall. I'm thrilled with how I'm maintaining my walking and my activity. I'm ready to see a loss on the scale this next week. I'm not discouraged. In fact, I'm super excited for this challenge this next week. So I want to hear, how did your week go? Comment below. Let me know. Did you gain? Did you lose? Was it what you expected? Are you on the Wendy plan with me this week, or have you tried it in the past? And what are your thoughts if you have? Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new, make sure that you subscribe. Hit that little bell so you're notified every single time that I upload a new video. Give this one a thumbs up. And one last thing before I go, I am going to include the recipe on the back of the weekly. The majority of you want to still see that. So that's going to be next slide of this video. So again, thank you so much for watching. I'll see all of you in the next video. Bye guys.